Desert Island camper van. Robinson Crusoe had Man Friday, and you guys have washed up together apparently on the shores of our beautiful tropical island. So, thanks for doing this, it's class. Do you want to, let's introduce you first of all. Noelle, you go first, just tell us about yourself in 30 seconds.
I am Noelle Galt, married to Terry. We have two daughters and five lovely little grandchildren, ranging in age from 17 down to just over a year old. So they keep us busy a lot of the time, and in church, help with brownies on a Monday night, which I love, done quite for a few years now, along with Lynn, who is the leader in charge. And as for Elizabeth, as most people probably know already anyway, we've been friends for a lifetime. We met when I was 10, going on 11. Elizabeth was just coming 12, I think. And we were new to Beaver. The houses were new, and we just became friends, and thankfully have remained so all these years.
Can you remember the first time that you met?
Yes. Well,
yes, we were just talking about it yesterday, you remember? Because I was saying, Noelle came to, Noelle and Barbara, another girl, came to our door, not back door, and says, is your wee girl coming out?
Yes.
Watching wee girl coming
out. Yes. And the funny thing about that is, because when I moved into Beaver, we moved in July, and Barbara was already there, and she lived a few doors down on the same side as me, and just opposite to where Elizabeth was going to live. And she came to my door, and that's exactly what she said to my mum, is your wee girl coming out?
And the rest is history.
And
the two of them have always been smaller than me.
Yes.
And then Elizabeth, tell us about yourself in 30 seconds or less.
I'm Elizabeth Wilson, married to Ken, as a lot of people know Ken. And we have one son.
I like that it took you a wee minute to count that up.
Thinking the grandchildren, thought I'd better save a son first. And we have two grandchildren, 7 and 4, who we mind a few times, and during the week, and that's about it. And I've always been coming to Beaver, and thankfully when we got married, I thought, oh, we're going to have to go to Ken's church, that's what you do. And he says, oh no, you take the guides, I think we should stay in Beaver. So that suited me down to the ground, you know.
And then we actually took the guides together as well.
Now,
Elizabeth was the boss, but
took the guides
sort of
for years, and then Noelle stopped when she had Heather, and then a few years later they needed somebody to help with the brownies, and that's how she got into the brownies, and she's still there.
And the rest is history again.
Great.
Well, given the long and storied history of your friendship, this is only the second time that we've done this on the desert island that we've got two people, and we're going to try to get you to guess each other's choices. So am I right in saying neither of you know what the other person is going to pick for your favourite book, song and all the rest of it? Right, so we're gonna try and guess, and if you get it wrong, it's not a problem. I mean, it will obviously reveal to the world that your friendship business. Yeah, exactly. It's just not quite what you thought it was, but you know, that's all right. Let's start with movie, and let's start with Elizabeth. Do you want to try and guess what is Noelle's Desert Island movie gonna be?
Well, it was just a guess. I would say maybe Sound of Music.
Oh my goodness, that's it.
There we go. We're off to a good start. Wow, okay, so
it's funny, it would either be that one or the one that I would probably pick.
Right,
for
okay,
me,
so, we'll reveal nothing just yet. Right, so let's talk about Sound of Music first. What is the reason for Sound of Music being...
Oh my goodness, from I was a small child, seeing the original one, I remember going with my mum and probably my sister and my brother. I think the four of us went together to see it in what was then the Odeon cinema in Belfast. Like, that was a real treat to go there, and that was the first time that I saw it. And then just as I grew up, oh my goodness, we watched it, and my girls came along and they love it. And I mean, I think not only do we know the songs, we nearly know every word in it. Not only, you know, it's just a wonderful, feel good, lovely film.
Brilliant, because it's actually, it is quite like it's quite dark as well. It's about a very dark part of history.
Yes, yeah? Mm-hmm. It absolutely is. Yeah.
So it's not as if it's all just cheery, happy sunshine. You know, it's actually about
and how they were going to have to totally change their whole life, and mm-hmm. I suppose also the facts based loosely is probably, I suppose, maybe on that true story and stuff. Mm-hmm. I just thought it was wonderful.
Yes. And are you a musical fan on the whole, or is mm-hmm. it just that one movie?
No, musical films would definitely be my absolute favourite.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right, okay. Yeah. Cool. Well, there we go. Pressure's on now, Noelle. What is going to be the movie of choice?
I was thinking about this, and I thought, if I hadn't picked The Sound of Music, I probably would have picked Mamma Mia for Elizabeth.
Is that right? Oh, brilliant, right.
Mamma Mia. Here I go again, my, how can I resist ya? Because I thought, I wonder which one I really like the best, because we love all the songs and everything in them, you know.
So they're both, so they're the top two movies for both of you?
Yeah,
both of them? Right,
yeah,
okay.
definitely.
Oh my goodness.
I know, that's
like,
good.
We have never even once, we both know that we love those films.
Yeah, Melissa said, and the songs and all the rest of it. There was another couple of films that I thought of, that I've watched over and over again, but I thought, a desert island, definitely either of those.
You would never get tired.
Because as well as that, you have the songs as well. Yeah. So you can go about singing them and all with it and all the rest of it. And Mamma Mia is such a feel-good one, really, you know. It really is, isn't it?
Yes,
you know?
And the thing is, if you were on a desert island, wouldn't there be nobody there to hear you singing?
No, well, this is it. You could belt it out.
Well, you'd be here. I guess on our desert island, you're here to hear each other sing, but that obviously will be fine. Within my soul.
When we were young, I was 19 and I got my driving test, and in those days you didn't go out too many places, and if we were out somewhere, set the guides or somewhere like that at night, we would have got into my car, and in those days you had, what do you call the big cassette things you pushed in, and you had those, and we had those ABBA and all the rest of it, and we would have driven around the country roads just for an excuse to drive around singing to it, because it didn't matter that we could hear each other, we weren't interested, we're not really sure we weren't, and we drove around singing
Olivia Newton-John.
That's right. Oh yeah, that's right. Olivia Newton-John.
Oh, so Great Grace is on the list
and the New
as well.
Seekers and all the rest.
Okay, right.
Are the Seekers.
So with Mamma Mia, can I confess a terrible thing?
Oh, you have to see it.
I'm not really a musical sort of a,
it is. My brother-in-law, you know Peter in Canada, he came over here for surgery on his ankle, and says, I'm not going, and we dragged him there, and he really agreed that it was feel good, and he loved it. We made him come and see Mamma Mia, and he's not an ABBA fan.
And do you know what's funny, because at the very very end of it, after all the things have rolled at the end of it, unexpectedly the four of them come back on dressed in the whole
ABBA gear.
But just as themselves, you know, well, obviously themselves, in the film, and they just start singing and they're laughing at the same time, and I still as hi, I would love to go back.
What fun. Yeah.
But it was just so much fun, wasn't it?
Because am I right in, so as I say, I haven't seen it, but I've heard people say some of the actors in it aren't maybe especially good singers.
Oh, no. Which makes it even nicer.
Yeah,
I think Pierce
really Brosnan
does. Maybe
none of the men really are singers, sure.
But you know that sort of was all part of the fun.
It's almost like karaoke.
And I think he didn't take himself too seriously. It was fun.
But
and
it's just so natural. It makes it so natural.
Yeah.
Doesn't it?
Yeah. When you're gone, how can I even
try to go on? Well, shall we go on to then, so is ABBA, well, let's find out, is ABBA also included in the favourite song? Shall we kind of link through from musical movies to musical music?
It's because we've got it all there.
Right, it's all, yes, the best songs are already there in the movies. Noelle, you can guess first this time, Elizabeth's favourite song.
Is the song or a hymn?
Oh.
I honestly am not sure if I would know. Well, I'm only guessing this because I suppose because we've been involved in the church over such a long time, we have favourite older style hymns, but we probably also each have a favourite newer. But definitely when we were growing up, guides and all that sort of thing, her favourite hymn definitely was The Church's One Foundation.
That's right. That's not what I was going to say.
It's not, okay.
But that is right. And I was going to say that's what it was when we were growing up and I really loved it. But then now we've been introduced to all these new modern songs.
Okay.
There's so many
hard.
That we love.
Yes, okay.
In fact, I always say my funeral is going to be very long because there's going to be a lot of
those songs.
Will
be like about 50
songs. But that is so right. That was my...
Yes, that was your favourite.
My favourite one as far as before all those modern ones came.
Okay, but something has pipped it at the post now, has it?
Well, again, it's hard to even choose between one of them because we do love them all.
Yeah.
And they all, you know, they really are. They're all wonderful. Which is why The Church's Foundation, it's not, you couldn't say it was my favourite anymore.
Mm-hmm.
But one I do like, and I always did think I liked, would have him a funeral. But I shouldn't think like that, but you know, you have to think. I like one that is going to affect other people and maybe let other people see what we have lived with and, you know, that mm-hmm. sort of thing. Amazing Grace, but not the old Amazing Grace. The new Amazing Grace, because I love the chorus on it.
My chains are gone.
Yes, I've been set free and all.
Yes, that's lovely.
Yeah. Yes.
My chains are gone. I've been set free. My God, my Saviour has risen me.
Was there one moment where you kind of realised that is now the my favourite hymn?
Well, I love singing it.
Uh-huh.
You know, and I love it. I love when I hear Amazing Grace, and it's going to be the new one,
mm-hmm.
even more so than the old one. Because Amazing Grace was a lovely, sort of saddish kind of hymn, and it sort of could have dragged a bit.
But
that.
The newer
but
version
this
is,
newer
so,
version
yes.
is so uplifting,
yeah,
isn't
it?
It really is. It really is, and
yes.
I just love that chorus.
And it's more... It kind of makes the words of all of the other verses quite personal, doesn't
it?
Say, I've been set free. There's also Amazing Grace. There's a really cool last verse, which was apparently is really old, was in the original,
uh-huh.
and then fell out of use for a little while, but has kind of come back into use again.
Uh-huh.
Now can I remember it? The earth shall soon dissolve.
Oh
us.
Yes,
you know
we've
that
had
one?
That one. Yes.
Yes.
The earth shall soon dissolve like snow, the sun forbear to shine. But God, you called me here below, will be forever mine.
I love that
verse. It
is
a lovely verse.
Good choice. Okay, so Elizabeth. Guess Noelle's, song, it can be any song, but yours is a hymn as well, is it? Have we got at least that much to go on?
Love Divine.
Love Divine. Well, again, do you know what? That was one of our wedding hymns. Was
ours
Love
too.
Oh, really? Yeah.
Yes. And I nearly picked it. You see, there's so many you could have picked.
I know.
Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven.
Yeah.
I loved.
Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven.
When both of us were married, not to each other, I guess Dad, but do you know what I mean? When we both had our weddings, as far as I can remember, both of us walked up the aisle to that.
That's right.
Because
I said that's what you had in yours, but
back in
the
day,
that's the ones we had.
When we had the robed choir, because we were in the choir, they walked into church in front of us.
Mm-hmm.
And Brian Mayne, who was our rector at that time, and he was there for quite a number of years, he did not like Here Comes the Bride.
Okay.
No.
Mm-hmm.
Not at all. And that was one of like a prerequisite for the wedding. Please tell me you're not having that.
Okay.
Not
well.
The aisle, so.
Well,
and then we said we were having the choir anyway, so then you know, he suggested we have a hymn, then the choir can walk up and then you can go up after. So that's why we had Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven.
Uh-huh.
So I still love to sing it in church.
Uh-huh.
And then the second hymn was
Love Divine.
Because we did love... That's the thing.
I couldn't have told you we both had the same house.
It's so very hard.
I couldn't have. I knew maybe you'd had Love Divine, but not the first one.
But no, would you pick... Would you know what a modern one?
Oh, your modern one for you. Because every night, I love that. Oh, I love that. Yeah. That's what we're saying all the time.
I absolutely love My Jesus, My Saviour.
Oh, yes. Okay.
Yeah. Especially with Jeffrey playing them, because he does all the wee bits in between. And I just... And Days of Elijah. Oh, my goodness. Again, all the wee bits in between, all the wee bits in the keyboard and all, and the big thing at the end. Oh, magical.
These are the days of Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord.
So can we sing them all on the desert island?
Oh, I think, well, you, on the desert island you can sing.
We're having quite a few.
In fact, actually, right, well, let's give you one more. I'm breaking all the desert island rules now, but if you were to have one non-hymn each, what would it be?
Other than ABBA, do you mean, as well?
Sound
of Music.
Or The Sound of Music, yes. Everything that's already been mentioned is off the table. But is there any other song or singer would have to come to the desert island?
Oh, I like Whitney Houston. Her songs are sad and all the rest of it, you know.
Oh, well, that's cool. Is there a particular song?
What do you call it? What's that one, The Greatest Love of All?
The Greatest Love of All. Okay.
That's another one, yeah. Mm-hmm.
What about you, Noelle?
Well, I quite like some of the show songs, you know, some of the songs from the shows and stuff. And there's a local guy who we love to go to see, Peter Corey.
Yes.
And he sings a song Miss Saigon, We Doi. And it's about all the children in Vietnam who are of mixed race for various, you know, for obvious reasons. But nobody really wants them in the end. And they're called We Doi. But he sings it with a mass choir behind him.
Very emotional.
And it would actually make your hair stand on end. It's so... But the unfortunate thing about that is he will only sing it. You know, if you go to see him in a show, very often he'll not have a big choir and like that behind him. But if we've been lucky enough to hear him sing it, maybe in the opera house or somewhere like that.
Things.
Yeah, where he sings that, and that is amazing. Just because it's really based on that awful story, you know. But the music is wonderful.
So, that's class. Yeah, that's like class. That. That's actually, you know, in... Here we are sitting beside the All Nations Bike Shed. That idea of you know reaching out to people who've been left struggling to find a place and a home and an identity and everything is
set.
So that's okay. That's your film and your songs, plural, very plural. So okay, Elizabeth, do you want to guess Noelle's book?
I sure not.
That's a bit tricky because I happened to say to you before we came in here that I don't read a book, and this is the book that I read, look through, and so she knows.
Okay.
So she doesn't have to guess too hard.
I couldn't have guessed a book, I have to say. I couldn't have guessed a book, but she does like Hello Magazine.
Is that right? Is that the choice?
Yes.
So Hello Magazine, now I know very little about it, but from my observation of it, it's quite, it's almost always royalty on the front, would that be right?
Yeah. Or people, there would be a lot of royal stories and stuff, and we do love royal stories and royal wedding things and all that sort of thing that you get in that book. And I worked with a girl for many, many years, and we used to share a Hello Magazine. She would maybe buy it, and then she would bring it in to me and read it. And so on. And people say, Terry, my husband always used to say, I'd love to meet the first person who actually buys a Hello Magazine, because she's passed on to so many other people.
Yeah, that's a good way to do it.
Sharing, isn't it?
It's just sharing, but I do love that. I love all the pictures and seeing all the lovely fashions and all of that.
And you get to see people's houses sometimes. Yes, is that part of the nosiness of it? It's like, here can...
Well, yes, I do like that, but I'm more into seeing what they're wearing and colours and all that sort of thing.
Yeah.
But I like the way nosy around the houses and stuff as well, obviously. Especially if it's somebody you know. Sometimes there would be people on it who you wouldn't know. But
That's an interesting thing as well. It's a it's kind of what we're doing here, isn't it? It's just interesting to hear people's stories. Sometimes you see them singing a song or acting in a movie or being a royal family member, but you don't actually know what makes them tick or what is their, like, what do they do to relax and what's their hobby and what's their interest and what's their, and just, I presume
I just,
that's the...
I just quite enjoy reading all about that.
And is there a particular, well, do you keep the Hello magazines then, or are they kind of disposable?
No, I did used to. And then we sometimes, well, used to give them to my mum or pass them around or something like that. And then many years later, when... after my mum had passed away, we were clearing out the cupboards down at home and found these two wardrobes piled high with Hello magazines.
So it's
sort of runs in the family.
No, magazines can take up a lot of space. I can affirm as a collector of Motor Home Motor Caravan Monthly magazine, I also have box loads.
You're the one
that
buys those.
I'm the one.
So we thought, oh my goodness.
And there's something, and just getting, you know, that's the reason you keep the old ones, is picking up one from 10 years ago and flicking through it again. It's like you've forgotten it all. You know, it's like having a new magazine again. So is there one, if we were very, very mean and said that you were only allowed to bring one magazine to the island, is there one in particular? Was there one interview or one feature in particular that you would be like, that's the one, I'm going to pick that one from the wardrobe?
Well, I suppose... rather than going for the happiest one, I think the saddest one that I would have thought of was after Princess Diana died. And I think just the whole tragedy of that whole story, and it filled magazines for weeks and stuff after that. So I think just the whole tragedy of that and the young children and everything, I think that's probably the one I would think of.
So right, Noelle, you get to now choose Elizabeth's book.
See, as you might tell, we don't often sit and discuss literature.
We'll not ask what you do sit and discuss.
The thing is, we never stop talking. Like, you know.
Well, I know.
We were out yesterday and talked.
I think that's sort of pleasant.
Well, I actually don't read a lot of books, because if I pick up a book at home and get interested in it, I don't want to put it down. So
she
everything's
left.
She
does love a Reader's Digest. And she does really love a Reader's Digest.
I do love a Reader's Digest, because you can read wee snippets of it and all the rest of it. But the only time I would actually read a book is on holiday, because you are, that's what you're doing. You're not planning to do anything and you're sitting there and you're reading it. So I have read books, and like Noelle, ones that I've had in school, and read different interesting ones and all the rest of it. But if I was on a desert island, I would take, you probably wouldn't know this, The People's Friend, Daniel.
Oh, I do know it.
Yeah.
Only because you used to buy it every year.
Oh, there you are.
Because, do you remember you used to buy her that every...
Yeah,
either you
because,
or your mummy.
Because your mummy liked The People's Friend.
Oh, yes, every week.
She read the magazine.
So these are all things. No wonder there's no news agent in Beaver anymore. One issue of everything was bought and then just did the rounds of everybody.
The People's Friend, Annual, it's not like a Bundy or a Beano Annual, it's not a big one. It's like a proper hardback book. But it is individual stories. So, and you know how anyone reading a book would say, I'll read a chapter? Well, I couldn't do that. So, but I could sit down and read a wee story.
Okay.
And they're
so
all
short stories?
Short stories. Okay. Yep. Instead of chapters, it's all different short stories. But young people, old people, sad stories, happy stories. But you get the start, the middle and the end. And that is perfect for me, because if I want to sit, I can sit and read that. The Reader's Digest, or read a page or random bits of it. I don't read it all. But, and you see, then if you take that to the desert island, by the time you've read the last one, you can start the beginning again, because you think you'll remember a story until you read the next one, and then you've forgotten it. And you see, you could read, you'd enjoy those wee stories too.
Short stories.
Right. Share the
Hello
books.
Magazine, People's Friends could be
absolutely.
Like, oh yeah, brilliant.
We could survive rightly in those.
And is there any one People's Friend story that you remember in particular? Any one issue that you'd be like, that's the one, I have to bring the annual from 1992?
No, I'll try and sneak all the annuals in. Not necessarily, you know. I think the ones that do enjoy it are about elderly people, and maybe somebody who's lonely and making friends with somebody and things. Those are nice. But there's also nice love stories and different wee stories about young families and things like that. And that, I think that's why I like it, because it is a variety. You know, it's not just all one, because I've read stories that are love stories and all the rest of it, but just like that, the wee variety.
Good stuff. Okay, so that's so
not very intellectual here.
But I'm impressed that you have. So our guessings have been almost all correct so far.
Pretty close, haven't they?
This is quite a tricky thing to guess about somebody else, I think. I'm not sure that I would even know about anybody else to say what is their favourite Bible verse. So who wants to go first? Noelle, do you want to try and see if you have any guess of Elizabeth's favourite Bible verse?
Do you know, to be honest, I haven't a clue.
Again, there's so many.
Mm-hmm.
You know, picking one out of them all is something, isn't it?
Do you know what? I'm just going to go with John 3.
Okay.
For God so loved the world.
Mm-hmm.
Well, is that your one?
Oh, well, we'll find out in a minute, right? So is that's not your one then?
No, that's not my one.
Right, okay.
No, that is a lovely one. Again, okay. That, you know, there's so many of them.
Mm-hmm.
Psalm 121. I will lift up my eyes to
Oh, that's lovely.
Mountains, as it used to be the hills, the same mountains now. Mm-hmm.
Yes, that's lovely.
You know. When you're praying, you have your head down, but for that, you do have to lift your head up. And that's when it all happens, when you lift your head after you've prayed. And I just think it's comforting.
It's a perfect one for Beaver. I always think it's lovely. Yeah. Like you say, when you're done praying, when you're done in church, when you come out the
and
door here
and
look and that.
Yeah.
4 o'clock the other day, the sun was shining on it. And it was dark and dull and all around here, but the sun was shining that we're coming down Beach Hill Road.
Yeah.
And it was nearly like yellow.
Orangey yellow.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, we saw it. Because
you should see it from your house, I suppose, do you?
Just the way we look down, there's a wee gap.
Yeah.
And the children were going home one day and I said to Terry, my goodness, look at the sky, it's amazing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It was in lockdown that we really noticed the world around us again. I'm sure we always went for walks and admired
definitely.
The scenery and admired the sunsets and stuff. But for those, especially the months when we were really, really stuck in the house, all of a sudden the garden and the hills and the sky and the sun and everything.
There was something kind about those days, wasn't it?
Yeah.
You know, it was nice.
Mm-hmm.
You did have time for those sorts of things.
Mm-hmm. And it just reawoke a wee sense of, like you say, there's God's handiwork all around
nature
us. There's
all
around.
It is.
And I think we're so lucky that we live in the area that we live in. And for us, we've always lived in the area, really. We're so lucky because there's so much beauty all around, everywhere, you know.
Yeah.
It's just a lovely place to be. And it was a really special place to grow up, wasn't it?
Oh, definitely. Mm-hmm. It really was. Like summer we played in the forest, didn't we? Came home with bunches of bluebells, dug up the primroses, which you're not allowed to do now. But our mummy's gardens were full of primroses, didn't we? And we pulled bluebells and brought them home and went to the...
Oh, the tombs.
The tombs, we went to the tombs. There was a family tomb there.
I was a bit scared about
now
those
it's all
places.
Fenced in. You can only look through the wires and see it, because we actually found it one day. But at that time, you were able to read the headstones
that's
and everything.
Class.
You know, just run about the forest, didn't it?
Yeah.
And you just went out and you came
down
home.
Minniburn,
and
we used to go fly down Minniburn Hill on our bikes and all to go to Minniburn. Well, that's where we went in the bikes. Really,
that's right,
it?
It's
great.
Down to Shaw's Bridge, and we really thought we were going miles. Like, you know, we were brave and going miles down to Shaw's Bridge, like, on our bikes.
Of course, when you think, though, back in the day, when we moved to Beaver, like, there was no main road here.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
it was a country
the Kearns Hill Road was, like, a wee country lane, almost.
I lift my eyes to the hills.
And the bus came through Newton Breda Village, and then just came on down into Beaver. And it's hard to nearly remember now.
Well, there's no carriageway.
Sure,
we can remember the carriageway being built.
Nothing.
And we went to Knockbreda Guides when we were sort of guides one night, and we walked to Knockbreda and we walked back, and they were making the carriageway. We were stepping over rocks, and I can you remember?
No.
Well. Should I guess John 3 or is there another one? John 3.
You should guess that. Yes.
Yes, well, that's a beautiful
one. I just think
one.
It's just perfect. And I think it just sums up everything.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's great. yes, it kind of sums up the whole story in the light of love, doesn't it?
Yeah.
That's not just telling you what happened or telling you a piece of theology of, you know, this is why Jesus came to the earth. It's to say that it's all rooted as God's love for the world.
It just sends the message out, doesn't it? It says it all in one
go. Well, that's sort of what I thought. It just says it, everything.
Mm-hmm.
It just says it all, really.
Yeah.
And that's sort of what everything else is based on.